Hey folks, this is Seth Mayo again, curator of astronomy for the Lohmann Planetarium, and welcome back for another edition of our Sky Tonight. And for this week, we're covering August 31st through September 6th, but we're also going to take a look at the entire month of September and just give a nice general preview of what to expect and things to look out for this coming month. And there's a lot to see, so let's get to it. Now for the month of September, the sun will be setting earlier and earlier as we go through the month, starting at about 7:45 at the beginning of September, and by the end of the month, we'll find that sunset will be at about 7:10. So let's actually speed up our time here and set our sun for at the beginning of the month around 7:45, and we'll make it nice and dark as the sun dips below the western horizon. We'll have a nice view of our sky. Now for this month, there's a lot going on with our moon, and right away on September 2nd is our full corn moon. And that's the celebration of a time when you normally harvest corn. And this has roots, pun intended, to Native American tribes who would harvest corn at this time of the year, maybe even harvesting late into the night when the full moon would be rising at this time of the year and utilizing some of that extra light from the moon. And so there's tradition with these moon names corresponding with the time of the year or with crops, either planting or harvesting various crops. After the full corn moon on September 2nd, we'll find that our moon will be getting closer and closer to this red, almost star-like object, which happens to be the planet Mars. And this is looking towards the east or southeast a bit after 10:30, and if you're out at least after 10:30, Mars and the moon will be high enough above the horizon to clearly see. So if we zoom back in, what we'll do is we're going to progress time forward through the week, and as we do, and you'll notice the date here, starting on September 2nd, the full corn moon at 11:30. If we speed up time, you'll notice the moon getting closer and closer to Mars. This is September 3rd, the 4th, and then by the late evening of September 5th or the early morning of September 6th, you will find the moon and Mars will be at their closest. And this is called a conjunction, when two or more objects get very close to each other. So we have the red planet Mars and the waning gibbous moon within about a degree of each other. A degree is an angular measurement in the sky. 1 degree equals about 2 full moon widths. So less than that is very close proximity. And the farther south you go, the closer these objects would be. If you went all the way down to South America, the moon would actually cover up Mars in what's called an occultation. So depending on where you are on Earth and the angle you see these objects in the sky will determine how close they are to each other, or if they even overlap. But at least here in North America, and particularly in Florida, they're going to be getting within a degree of each other in the east after 10:30, evening of September 5th, or early morning September 6th. So you should be able to capture this through a telescope or binoculars. So if you are an astrophotographer or just want to see these two objects close with some binoculars, this will be a great pairing of these two solar system objects together in the sky. If you continue following the moon after the conjunction on the 5th and 6th with Mars, you'll notice that it will move through the eastern sky if you're looking in the early morning before sunrise, and the moon will slide through some of these wintertime stars and constellations that are now up at this time of year in the early morning. And by the 10th, you'll find a half-lit moon. This is last quarter as the moon is going through its waning phases. You're seeing less and less of it. And then as we continue further into the month, we'll get to the 12th, 13th, and then by the 14th, in the middle of the month, you'll notice the moon will join another non-twinkling star-like object just above the eastern horizon. And this is another planet, this time the brightest planet in our sky, which is Venus. And so there it is. And earlier in the year, we were talking about Venus in the west after sunset. It has transitioned to the east before sunrise. And it's really nice in the morning if you can find the crescent moon and even a little bit of earth shine when the reflected light from the earth actually shines back onto the night side of the moon and gives you that little bit of that light little area on the night part of the moon, and then the brightest planet, Venus. They won't be as close as the Mars-Moon conjunction, but still a nice pairing. And for those early morning folks out there, like taking walks in the morning or maybe on the beach or something, you'll have these two objects to see in the middle of the month, particularly on September 14th. And in the second half of the month, we'll find that the moon will again be located in the southern part of our sky, as it was recently, moving through those summertime constellations, past the galactic center, and again getting really close to the planets Jupiter and Saturn in the more in the south-southeast. For stars and constellations this week and for the month of September, we can officially say goodbye to the binary star system Spica and the constellation Virgo the Maiden that it's part of. We still have an opportunity to see the star Arcturus here inside Boötes the Herdsman. Arcturus is one of the brightest stars in our sky. And looking in the south, even though we're getting into the fall, you'll still see the summer constellations of Scorpius, that S-like figure that is this giant scorpion, and the teapot shape looking constellation that is Sagittarius. They'll be pretty high in the south still, and really high up, pretty much straight up, right when it gets dark this month, is something called the summer triangle, which we've spoken a lot about in the past, this asterism that you see here. And those three stars are part of very prominent constellations: Cygnus the Swan, Aquila the Eagle, and Lyra the Harp. And if we look towards the east, we will start to see more of these fall constellations. And as we move a little bit later into the evening for the eastern part of the sky, we can start to see this big square shape of Pegasus right here. And looking even to the northeast, better views of the W constellation, which is Cassiopeia, which is a queen, and her daughter Andromeda right here. So these are some constellations to look for, to look forward to for this time of year, and some that are from this past summer but still very high in the sky and easy to spot for this month. And lastly, as you know, in September we celebrate the beginning of fall and end of the summertime. And that is the time of year when the path of the sun crosses the equatorial line in the sky, Earth's equator projected to the sky. And in that crossing point, we have two of them. The vernal equinox is in the spring, and this one in the fall is called the autumnal equinox. So we'll have about equal amount of day and night. So we can celebrate that on Tuesday, September 22nd this year. So these are the great things to see this week and for this month. And in the next couple episodes, we'll talk more specifically about the great events and objects you can see for the month of September pertaining to that week. So hopefully you get a chance this month to really celebrate the sky, celebrate the change of seasons, and the lovely conjunctions going on with the moon and various planets. Thank you again for tuning in to our Sky Tonight program. Again, stop by the Lohmann Planetarium if you have the time, where we're doing live shows. We're doing it safely, and we'd love to see you in person, but again, online as well. And please give us your questions. We'll try to answer those online too when we can. We love questions and trying to answer them and really connect with you all. And we really appreciate the community and what you've all done to support us through all of this. So take care, happy stargazing, and happy fall celebration.